Hi friends, welcome to Crazy for DB. In this fifth video in the series of PLSQL lessons, today we are going to study the syntax and use of conditional control structures or conditional statements. Conditional control structures or conditional statements are part of every programming language, and so they are of PLSQL also. Conditional control statements are used to execute such lines of code which are required to be executed when a condition is true and not when the condition is false, or maybe different lines of code under different conditions. We will take very powerful examples to understand the concept. Keep watching this video until the end. Now, before we begin, I will advise you to keep focus on learning while you watch this video. The code of all the programs which we are considering here have been shared in the description box below, so that if you want to try, you may copy the code from there. If you have visited this channel for the first time or you have not done it before, then hit the subscribe button with also a click on the bell icon to stay tuned with the future updates and uploads. Now we turn to the learning session. Here the first control statement that we are going to learn is if then and if, that is the simple if. Now this particular statement, conditional statement, is used to execute a line of code if certain condition is satisfied and bypass the line of code if the condition comes out to be false. So this is the simple if, and here we are going to take an example of to check if a number is even. So here the code is there. I will copy this code and we will take this code to the Oracle environment in the SQL star plus. Here we come. Now there is a number variable declared over here. Then I am accepting a number from the user and getting it stored in this variable num. If mod num of 2 is equals to 0, that means that the number is even, because the mod of the even number with respect to 2 is 0. Then we print this message dbms underscore output dot put line, the number is even and that is end if. So this line of code gets executed exactly when this condition comes out to be true. Otherwise this will bypass and the program will come to an end. This is an exception section. If the user inputs something else, that is say character or date instead of number, then we have to handle the exception. This is a catch-all exception. I have covered the exception in a different video. You can visit the video, the link of which has been provided in the description box. Now we will execute this program. I am inputting the number 56. You know that this is an even number, and so the message getting printed is the number is even. Now I will again execute it. Say this time I input the number 57, which is an odd number, and so this code is getting bypassed and this message is not printed, because it will only enter into this if zone if this mod num of 2 is 0, or that is when the number is even. Actually this code, this if structure does not specify anything if the condition turns out to be false. It only specifies the lines of code which are supposed to be executed when the condition turns out to be true. So if in a case, in a situation where you have two different codes to be executed, if it is true, then one set of lines of code, and if that condition turns out to be false, then another set of lines of code, then we are used to then we are supposed to use the another if with else. So this is another case of if, where it is if then else ending. So if the condition is satisfied, then execute this code. Else means if the condition is false, then execute this code, and that is the ending. Now we again take the same program to declare if the input number is even, that is the first part, or odd if the condition turns out to be, if it is not even, then obviously it is odd. So we are actually taking the extension of the same program as we have covered before, and I will get this code copied from there into the Oracle environment and see rest of the code is same. Here there is some change. You can see that this part is same as before, that when mod of num of 2 is 0, then DBMS output dot put line the number is even. But this is the else part, that is when this condition turns out to be false, then this part of the code will get executed and it will print that the number is odd. So we will execute it. Again I will input the value, say 56, which is even. So it is printing the message the number is even. I will again execute it with say number 57, and you see that it is printing the number is odd, because that is going in the else part of this if, because the condition of mod num comma 2 equals to 0 is turning out to be false for 57. As far as this exception is concerned, say if I input say a character value, then you see that value has to be a number. So that is actually the exception handling part of this block. Here if because this particular program has been designed to only test if the input number is odd or even, we cannot expect an input of character type into this program. Now if there are several conditions, now these two if structures that we have seen, conditional structures that we have seen, are dealing with exactly one condition, that is if it is true, then execute a line of code or bypass it, or if the condition is true, execute it, execute a certain line of code, and if it turns out to be false, then execute the second set of lines of code. But if we are supposed to deal with multiple conditions where there are different lines of codes required to be executed under different conditions, or per se, if I tell it in other way, that if there are multiple conditions and different lines of code, and I want that a certain line of code should get executed for the first condition that is turning out to be true, then we have to use a control structure called as if then else if. So that is this if then else if then else and if, and this is actually an example with multiple conditions with different actions under different condition. It is used in situations to carry out an action on the first of the condition coming true. So that is the purpose of this if then else if then else and if control statement. Here we are going to consider a bit of difficult problem, because there are multiple conditions to be dealt with, and so I am considering a problem here of calculating the salary with a formula where salary equals to basic plus allowance, and that allowance basically is specified in terms of percentage of basic according to the slabs of basic, and there are the following terms and conditions of the program. And the first one is basic cannot be less than 1800 and more than 10,000. Then second is basic between 1800 and 3,000 allowance is 120% of the basic. For the slab of basic above 3,000 and up to 5,000, allowance rate is 130% of the basic, that is 10% more than the previous case. Then basic above 5,000, that is the third slab, and up to 7,000, allowance rate is 140% of the basic. And then finally, if the basic is more than 7,000, the allowance rate is 150%. Our user is allowed to input the value of the basic, and in the output, our program is required to print the basic, the calculated allowance, and the salary, which is supposed to be calculated as basic plus allowance. So that is actually the statement of the problem, a bit longer, because it has to match with the conditional control structures that we are supposed to learn. Now I will demonstrate the solution to this problem with this code. We will take this code to the Oracle environment again. Let me explain the flow of this program. Basic, that is a variable which I am declaring to capture the value of basic. Salary, same to capture the value of salary. Allowance, to capture the salary, to capture the value of allowance. Then min base, that is the minimum basic that is allowed, that is 1800. Then max basic that is allowed is 10,000. Then the first limit on the basic, that is 3,000. Then second limit on the basic, that is 5,000, so that there is a slab formed between 1800 and 3,000, and then 3,000 and 5,000. Then next slab from 5,000 to 7,000, so that is the third limit for the basic, that is 7,000. And then the different rates of allowances have been defined over here. That is, the first rate in the first slab is 120%, then second rate is 130%, then the third rate is 140%, that is for the third slab between 5,000 and 7,000, and for 7,000 above, this is 150%. And then you can see that I am declaring one exception, that is user defined exception, invalid over here, to take care of if the user inputs some basic value which is not in the range of 1800 and 10,000, and so that is supposed to be handled as an exception, and I am creating a user defined exception for this purpose. To come to the body of the program, we are accepting the value of the basic from the user in this statement. And then actually the main part of the program that we are supposed to learn, that is the control structure, okay, is this highlighted part over here. If basic less than min base or basic greater than max base, that is the basic is not in the range of 1800 to 10,000, then raise invalid, that is what we have, you know, declared it as an exception over here. If it is not, then obviously the basic is in the range, and then we are supposed to deal with those different slabs and calculate the amount of allowance applicable to that slab, and that is basically done over here. Else if basic between min base and base lim 1, that is for the first limit from the minimum basic 1800 to 3000, then allowance is supposed to be calculated basic into allowance divided by 100, because all the rates of the allowances have been given here in terms of the percentages, and so allowance divided by 100. So also if the basic greater than base lim 1, that is above 3000, and basic less than equals to base lim 2, that is below 5000, so that is the second slab where the allowance rate is 130% as allowed to, that is allowed to divided by 100 into basic. Then similarly for the third slab, and then the else part, that is when the basic is above 7000, so So this particular code that is allowance 4, that is 150% will become applicable. So that is how the allowance is calculated. Finally, we get the value of the allowance to help us calculate the salary. Salary colon equals to basic plus allowance. The value of allowance is coming from this if structure, and the basic plus allowance will be assigned to the salary. This is the series of DBMS output dot put line statements to print the basic allowance and salary held in the variables basic allow and salary, as you can see over here. That is actually getting copied unnecessarily. I will just paste that again. Yeah, so this is the program, and as ever there are exceptions. When value underscore error, then DBMS output dot put line basic has to be a number again, because as you can see the basic has to be numeric, and if somebody enters a series of characters etc., then we are supposed to handle that as a value error. Then when invalid, that is when the basic is not in the range of 1800 to 10,000, then it will output the message that is basic must be in the valid range. And so now we will execute it. Say for example the basic is 4500, and then you see that basic allowance and salary values are getting calculated over there. If I am supposed to demonstrate the else part of this if structure, then I will have to input the salary above 7000, so I am inputting 7500, and so you see that this is calculating for the basic 7500, the allowance is 11250, and the total salary, that is sum of basic and allowance, is 18750. If somebody inputs the value say 1500, that is less than the basic allowed, so then you see that the basic must be in the valid range. And if somebody inputs the value of basic as some string of characters, then it says that basic has to be the number. So that is the explanation of the program that we have created for handling multiple different conditions to execute different lines of code according to the condition particularly satisfied. Now in Oracle 9i they introduced an equivalent of this if else if structure, and that is also the part of many programming languages, that is case control structure. Actually case came up late in Oracle. Case was introduced in Oracle 9i actually. Until then there was no case statement in Oracle. It is equivalent to if else if structure demonstrated as above, but simplifies it by taking an expression only once, of course in normal use, because there are two uses of the case control structure, or rather we can say that case can be used in two ways. One is the normal use and the other is the searched use of the case. So that is in the normal case, normal use, there is only one expression you are supposed to provide, and no repeated expression is required to be provided. I will show you the generalized code over here. It tests this for equality of the value. So the generalized form of the case in the normal use is like this case expression. So that is you have to use only for once, as I have said above. So there is some expression. This expression can be a variable or some arithmetic expression, the result of which can be some output, arithmetic output. Then v1, so you see that there is no comparison operator allowed to be used in this case. The expression is compared, just I told you before, that expression is compared with this V1, V2, Vn, etc. for those different when clauses, only for equality. You are not allowed to use any comparison operator like less than, greater than, etc. when you are using the case in such normal form. Then accordingly, whether this expression is equals to V1, then there is some action code 1 getting executed. If it equals to V2, then some action 2 lines of code getting executed. Similarly, there may be V3, V4, Vn, and the different actions of code will be executed. But if this is optional part, if the expression does not result into either of V1, V2, V3 or Vn, etc., then optionally you can specify to execute or to perform some action, that is some code you can write over here in the else part to be executed. So that is how actually this normal form of the case structure is. Now we are considering a simple problem over here. The problem says that consider a school which has alternate day, half day and weekly off on Sunday. So the school runs one day full, then next day half, like, and Sunday is the weekly off. And the program is written so that we want to display the name of the day and whether it is half day or full day or holiday, along with the name of the day. And the input is numeric weekday, that is from 1 to 7 with 1 as Sunday, because we know that in a week there are only 7 days. So here is the code I have written for this example, and we'll copy this code to be taken to the Oracle environment. We'll execute it over there. I am declaring the variable over here dayNum. There is an exception. This dayNum has been declared, then there is an exception ERR, because we know that the value for the dayNum has to be between 1 to 7, and if it is beyond this range, then obviously we have to raise this ERR exception and tell the user that it is out of the range. Then case dayNum, that is an expression we are using only for once, and then this dayNum value is getting compared with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 for equality, and then accordingly we are having this DBMS output dot put line. It is the name of the day. It is the name of the day, and whether it is weekly off or what, whether it is full day, whether it is half day, etc., is getting displayed in the output. This is the else part, that is if the day is 7, because we are considering the cases only when it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, etc. But 7 we are not considering, and so obviously if it is not between 1 to 6, among 1 to 6, then it is of course is going to be the 7. And so the DBMS output dot put line, because it is the Saturday, that is 7th day, is getting printed over here. This when ERR, then numeric weekday 1 to 7 only accepted, that is the message we want to show to the user. And if somebody is inputting any value other than number, then we have to again tell input must be between 1 to 7. So that is the explanation of the code in the block. Now we will execute it. Say day number, say 4. So it is Wednesday, and the school is full day. Then suppose I input say 3, so that should be Tuesday, and the school should be half. If I want to demonstrate the else part, I will input 7. So you see that it is Saturday and half day. If I input out of the range of 1 and 1 to 7, then numeric day has to be between 1 to 7. That is the message you are getting. And if I input some string, again the error is getting handled over there with this value underscore error, and it says that input must be between 1 to 7 only, that is numeric. So that is the normal form of case. But as I told you, that case can also be used in the search form. Actually, the search form does not take any expression, but different conditions specified in the when condition then clause. So it is like if then else form of structure. So instead of if, it use when. Otherwise, the rest of condition then remains the same, and it does not take any common expression, but it takes the condition in the different when clauses, and those conditions are logical, as we have seen in the case of if. We are actually going to solve the same problem as we have taken above, that is for the calculation of salary, and at this time we are going to solve it with the case. So I will again copy the code from here. And we will execute it. So here actually that case structure is there, rest of the part is same, and you can see that just that if has been replaced with when, otherwise everything is same, and all the formula etc. okay, that we have seen in that case are also appearing over here. Then there is a series of DBMS output dot put line statement to display the value of basic allowance and salary, and the same exceptions also we are finding over here. Now I will execute this again, say with the value 4500. So you are getting the basic 4500, allowance 5850, and the sum total of this, that is salary, is 10,350. If I want to demonstrate the else part, 7500. Okay, you see that basic 7500, allowance 11,250 and 18,350 is the output. And if it is beyond the range, say 1500, so basic must be in the valid range, that is what it says. If it is some numeric value, then again the basic has to be the number, that is through the exception of a value underscore error, it is showing the message to the user. So that's all for now about the conditional statement in PL SQL. Keep on watching this series of lessons on Oracle PL SQL. Share the videos generously on your social media to help the knowledge reach to those who need it. Visit the description box for code of all these programs. I have already told you that, the code you can pick from the description box and try it yourself on your laptop or desktop, whatever you have at your home. Thanks for watching.